it up on the last day. God has made us. Continue with our next hymn. In the name of Jesus, amen. We pray with you. Father in heaven, we thank you and the hope that we have. Jesus lives. Hank now resides with you. Strengthen this family in the hope and the promise that we have. In his name we pray. Amen. Jane and family, friends, hear the promises of God and give them to us. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who looks to the Son and believes in him should have eternal life, and I will raise him up. And I That's sure. Himself. And that promise.
And it's ours.
In the midst of your sorrow and your grief and your sadness, that is our hope. That is our promise. Jane, I don't know if you in typical fashion, Carol came up and shook my hand and we visited, and it was a few weeks after that. Call me Hank. She said, everybody calls me Hank. I didn't realize that he liked Hank, but he
didn't really like Carol, and then he told me the rest of the story, that in a long series of boys, his parents wanted a girl.
And Hank held up the
family tradition of being a boy, and he gave him the name Carol.
And he didn't like the name. And people got it wrong all the time. When Verizon and when people continued to get it wrong, and you said yourself he should
have gone by or he wanted to go by C.
Lundy. Well, today as we gather, if it's okay with you, I'm going to use the name Hank. And we're going to talk about not
the name that he didn't like, but we're going to talk about the name that he loved.
And that wasn't Hank. Was child of God. 2 months after Hank was brought
into this world, his parents brought him to the waters of holy baptism, and there, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, God gave him a new name. Gave him the name
Child of God.
And he gave him an identity that is not changed by the world, is not influenced by sickness or death, is not even changed by what happened in the last few days.
In the promises that God gave to Hank when he baptized him, when he called him to be. When Hank was baptized, he was given promises. Promises that are
all through the scriptures, promises that we will stand on today for our hope, knowing that God is coming.
God gave him this promise. He and is baptized will be saved. That's a sure and certain promise that Hank is now living in. 2 months after he was
born, the waters of holy baptism flowed upon his head.
Of God. And there in the waters, Christ claimed him. Christ faithed him. Christ forgave him all of his sins. That's the hope. That on that first Easter
morning, when Jesus rose from death and holy grass, another promise is given.
We heard it at the beginning of the service. For if we have been united
with him, with Jesus,
in a death like his, we shall
certainly be united with him in the resurrection of our Lord.
This is a promise from God. Shall certainly
be united with him
in a resurrection like his. Not because of any.
Not because we've lived the perfect Christian life. Not because we've been a faithful father and husband. But because of what Jesus
did on the cross when he forgave him. And he made him his son. And now he has kept his
promise.
86 years ago, Hank died in the old sinful
Adam and him was drowned, and a new man, a forgiven man, a son of God.
Name, child of God. And early on that Thanksgiving Day morning, God kept that promise. He was with him his whole life.
Continued to watch over him, guide him, direct him, forgive him, and give him hope
and peace. And on that morning, he gave him eternal life. He took Hank home to be with him. And now he rests with Jesus. 3 weeks or well, 3 weeks ago or so, I was when we sat around your kitchen and we received the Lord's Supper together, and we talked about hope and promise and the forgiveness of sins and all of those things. We start talking about cars. And you told me in the course of his life that he had had over 100. What a great thing. I love cars.
I don't know much, but we were having a great conversation.
We're sitting there at the table. He says, Pastor, you have to see.
And I thought he was going to take me to the other room and show me another picture of a car or something that he destroyed.
But instead he brought me into your living room and he showed me something that one of you sent to him from California. It was the plaque with his badges, his stars that he had from the fire department. And he was so proud, not of them, but proud of the way that he was able to serve. And he showed me each one, and he showed me
exactly what it meant and what the truth was at that time.
All of them continued to show how proud he was to serve others. How proud he was in the
way that God had used him in this world.
Hank knew clearly who he was. He was a Marine. Thanks be to God. He was a fireman. He was a paramedic. He was an RN. Faithful husband of 65 years, and he loved you, Jane. And he worried about you as well. And Hank knew also that he was a sinner, no doubt. That first hymn that we sang, or that sermon hymn that we sang, Chief of Sinners, Jane, you requested that, your favorite hymn. But I know near and dear to Hank as well. That day when I come over to visit you and Hank and we have the Lord's Supper, we started together, the three of us, that we're sinners, that we don't deserve any gifts from God because of what we've done. But by his grace, this world to forgive you and to forgive Hank and all of us. Jesus has sustained Hank, and now Jesus is to be with him. That confession of sins that we went through at the beginning might seem sometimes to be best before our God, and in the midst of that confession, it drives us back to Jesus died for sinners. Jesus rose for sinners. Jesus rose for Hank. We sit here in the loss and the mourning.
There is absolute hope that Jesus,
in his resurrection, has taken Hank home to be with him. And Hank rests with Jesus. No more sorrow. No more sadness. No more struggles breathing.
No more worrying about heaven. No more sin, sadness. No more death.
Waits with Jesus for the day when Jesus steps upon the earth and Hank's body and all the
body of those who have died will be raised again, and all things will be made what has been established.
St. Paul is clear. Reading that we heard today, the wages of sin is death. But death does not have the
final word. Death does not issue the final judgment, and death cannot steal away the whole benefit.
Which is the same hope that we have today. Jesus Christ rose. He rose again and stood upon the earth. Hank is at rest with Jesus. The very things that would try to steal, things that Jesus has died and forgiven, and gives us the confidence to know that he lives, and all who believe in him to life again. Hank no longer struggles. destroying all of the with him. Hank is at peace, waiting for the day when we join him or when Christ comes again and raises all people. Paul says the way God is eternal life. Dear saints, Christ is risen. Thankful. He lived in that baptismal hope every day of his life, and now he rests in Jesus. Your family and friends, don't be afraid on this day. He rests for eternity. One day we will be there as well. Believe in the promises that God has. These promises. For one who has died, has been set free from sin. Now we have died with Christ. We believe that we also will live with him.
Don't be afraid. Trust in the promises that God has given to us. All that the Father gives to me will come to me. And whoever comes to me, I will never pass by.
Anchors with Jesus, because Jesus kept his promise. Don't be afraid. Listen and
believe and trust in the promises. And this is the will of him who sent.
That I should lose
nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the mountain.
Trust in Jesus. Trust in the promises that he gave you. He has given to you. For this is the will of that's our hope. In the name of Jesus, amen. Please stand as we come to our Savior in prayer. Let us pray to the Lord. Body of your Son, give to your whole church in heaven and on earth. Lord, in your mercy, grant that all who have died to sin and rise to death and the grave to our joyful seated with him at your heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, give to the family of Hank and to all who mourn an assured confidence Lord, in your mercy, give courage and faith to the bereaved, that within the communion of your church they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the assurance of a holy and a and in the joyful expectation of eternal life, always in love, for help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life. Our thanks for him. Bring us at last to our heaven. Face to face in the joys of paradise. Lord, in your mercy. O God of all grace. Thanks that by his death he destroyed. We shall live also. That neither death nor life will separate us from your love, Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God. Please be seated.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Lord, now let your word has the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die.
Lord God, our shepherd, comfort us with the Christ, your Son, our Lord, reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God. Let us bless the Lord. The Lord lift up his countenance.
Thank you.
Family and friends, thank you for joining us today, and I pray that you find hope and comfort. Same hope that Hank is. Savior lives, and Hank is now resting with him. It is 11:45. To be at the cemetery by 11:15. So as we get into our cars and making our way to the National Cemetery.